Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. I am doing something different today. I wanted you to experience a little bit of who I actually am, which is a very deep, intuitive human just trying to live on this planet. So I am excited to sit down with two amazing women, Laura Polko, who is hair genius extraordinaire, also my soul sister, and the founder and creator of The Pattern, Lisa Donovan. Thank you. One time for you.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here. I'm so excited to be here with you. I also just wanted to like highlight you as a woman, business owning, successful, strong women, but also if you guys don't know about The Pattern, you have to get on it right now. Always been the type of person that's like, I'm an answer seeker. You know, I have tattooed on me, seeker. Like I'm always looking for more ways to understand myself, to like understand why I'm relating to things the way that I do. Astrology is obviously something that most people grew up aware of.
Yes.
Whether it's like your silly little blurb in like Cosmo magazine.
Totally.
Or the New York Times or whatever. But you believe that it's so much bigger than just that.
I do.
Little blurb.
Yes. I definitely did not grow up a huge astrology person. I came from this very like logical home, you know, no religion, no spirituality. Yeah, my background, I actually started as a YouTube content creator, 2005, like when YouTube started. And it was just like, oh my God, this is gonna be huge. And what it became is sort of what I thought it would happen much quicker.
Right.
Anyway, I had this channel. It was sort of a successful channel, but there was no money, so you had to work like a job and be feeding this beast because everybody wants the content.
Wow.
Behind the scenes, on a personal level, my life around that time sort of fell apart, and I was...
What was your transit happening?
Oh my gosh, at the start of 6 years of Pluto.
Which I knew it, I was like, you're gonna say Pluto. Oh.
Yeah, it was just really... Yeah. It was more like a reckoning with myself, the choices I'd made, my own...
Right.
It's always about you. And it was sort of my own self-betrayal, my own sort of codependence, all this stuff. And my life took a massive change and I was confused and lost and realized I knew nothing about anything. And had my first astrology reading during this time.
Huh.
With, you know, going into it, just not really thinking much like that. It's sort of some cheesy new agey thing.
Right.
So it was amazing, and I was sort of shaken because it was like, wow, these are my insecurities, my fears, what I'm going through, my aptitudes.
Right.
And I became obsessed. And just, you know, reading after reading and researching, and there was nothing out there that kind of did what that did. I couldn't find like an app or a website that sort of mimicked that. And I was like, oh, I have to do that, obviously. And so I set out to do that 7 years ago, thinking it'd be super easy. And of course,
I mean, it's also so specific and so spot on.
Yeah.
And make people feel seen. I feel like The Pattern makes you feel really seen.
This is how I found you.
Yeah.
So I'm in a fitting one day with Channing Tatum, and he is like this, you know, he's like very intuitive, he's very deep, he's very sweet, and he's like, we walk in the room, and he's like, are you on The Pattern? And I was like, no, what are you talking about? This was probably, I don't know,
this was like years ago, probably even longer.
And I was like, no, what's The Pattern? And so he tells me about it, I download it on this, he like would not let me leave this house until I downloaded it, right? So I download it, and we part ways. Like I, you know, I go about my day. And then he posts this video that went everywhere.
I saw it everywhere.
And he basically was like, what did he say? It was so funny. Yeah. You know what? Cut to the video of Channing here.
Okay. I need some answers, okay? Cause I don't know if I'm late to this or if I'm early to this, but what is this pattern? It's an app. I just downloaded it called The Pattern, and it asked me to put in my birth date and my time of birth. By the way, how are you supposed to know your time of birth? I hope anyone that does this has a parent that loves them and is half responsible, because I don't even know how I would have figured that out. Anyways, how do you know what you know about me, Pattern? You know what? Pattern people, you should just call me. That's what should happen right now. You should just DM me. If you know so much, you know how to get in touch with me now, don't you? So just do that. Just, I need answers right now.
And I think that's sort of what like broke the internet for you. I could be wrong. It broke the app. So that's how we met, how we found you. And then cut to, You came to LA, you were doing readings for people, and you did mine, and you did Laura's, and we just wanted to share it with everyone. So whether you are, you know, familiar with astrology or not, I really just wanted to, like, you know, showcase you as a woman, by the way, because being a woman and starting a business and running a business is not easy, as we all know. Yeah.
But thank you guys for being on it and sharing it and talking about it and having me here. But yeah, we try and get it to the exact moment of your birth. We think of it as above, so below, where the planets were in the sky at the time of your birth. You are the creative expression of the universe in that single moment in time. And the moon changes sign every 2.5 days, your ascendant every 2 hours. So we're getting way more specific than just the month you were born, right? Your moon was in the sign of Aries.
Okay.
And we think of the moon as the lineage, where you've come from, as though you've lived many lifetimes as this moon. And when you come into this life, that's sort of all you know. And then your soul goes on this journey, and it's got some things it's going to have to deal with that maybe it doesn't want to deal with. And yours...
Definitely me.
Yes, yours was in Aries. So this is the lineage of the warrior, the protector, you know, very... intuitive, it's action oriented, it's very goal oriented, very commitment oriented. What is it, I want to achieve it. You know, it's like a modern day athlete in a way too. Like almost every really good athlete has Aries in their chart.
That is me.
But you have a complex to it that we spoke about, and this is a really unique signature. And again, when I look at someone's chart, there's a spectrum of things. So I see you have Pluto to your moon in Aries. And that tells me you've had to deal with some serious underworld, disempowering, overwhelming, painful experiences in your life.
Yes.
It takes that Aries, it takes that power, and it puts this sort of intensity into it. And it's trying to force the Aries out of its comfort zone. It's trying to make it feel disempowered in a way, and to surrender to the feelings, to the emotions. To lose sort of control of things, and then through that you rise from the ashes.
So I don't think I've shared it on YouTube, this is on the internet, but I did get sober when I was 17 years old. I dealt with really horrifying bullying from the time I was in the third grade until I was 17. And I was ostracized, bullied, attacked constantly, every day of my life. I have no positive memories of those times of my life. And not to say that that makes me an addict or that makes me an alcoholic, because it doesn't, but my response to that pain was, I don't know how to process this. I'm such a sensitive being. Drugs and alcohol numbed the pain for me, which of course led to a really crazy drug addiction, which thankfully ended in, you know, at 17. And I've been sober ever since, not a sip, not a puff, nothing, God willing, you know. But again, none of that makes me an addict. It's just was sort of my soul journey, the battles that I had to fight in that time. And it was really the only way I knew how to process the pain that I was in, was to just like numb it out, you know, and nearly killed me. When I checked into rehab, they basically said you would have been dead within a week if you didn't get here when you got here.
Whoa.
So every step of the way was like, I gotta really, and as you said, goal oriented in my Aries, to just like tunnel vision, this is the
laser
goal.
Laser focus.
I'm not gonna give up until I, you know, succeed in this way. And I've sort of like, that's how I think I've gotten to where I've gotten, because I'm just very focused and succeeding, I guess, in the things that set my soul on fire. Like, this is not for everybody. What we have to deal with every day is not easy.
Oh, I say that all the time. I feel like anybody that does what we do definitely has deeper self-worth stuff. Because to put yourself in a scenario where you're constantly rejected, or like as soon as you feel like, oh, it's fine, like we're safe or whatever, like it could take a turn. And a lot of times you can say it's not personal, but there is a component of it that is. And like that happens, but that's to put yourself willingly in that scenario all the time, like you have to, everybody that is there, it's really interesting.
And you know, all of this stuff we say is intentional, and that's the power of it, that like your soul before coming in chose this to some degree because it's seeking something. And you have it to your moon, so you have Saturn, and your Venus is in Scorpio, so you're the Sag, Scorpio, and you're Capricorn rising. And we spoke, you have a very unique signature of being born where your Venus was hidden behind the sun when she was born in the darkness, but she was also retrograde. There's only like a week out of a 584 day cycle that you could have been born at that time, and it just makes you a very unique, alchemical, interesting butterfly Venus.
Yeah. I'm like, but then what?
I know. And then I'm like, I know.
But then the flip side is.
It's just that thing too. This is all about just owning your unique path and not comparing yourself. Because we get exactly, like you look at somebody who's, oh, it all seems so easy, and you know,
totally.
Just be on your path and understand and accept that and own that. That's what it was for me. It was sort of a sigh of relief and surrender when he told me, because I was like, oh, I can just stop. Yeah, and your chart, you know, in your Capricorn, that it's a very, like we talked about, it's a very powerful, very boss kind of chart when you put Scorpio and Capricorn. And Capricorn is ruled by Saturn, so that's also that thing of wanting to manifest in the world and make things happen. And very committed to that, but it's very hard on itself too. Like, there's a lot of
like. Yeah,
it's
never good enough.
Yeah, it's never good enough.
We're both so hard on ourselves.
Yeah.
It's so stupid. Sometimes you're like, your body really needs a day off. But then it's like, if you do take the day off, then you're like, I should have done that. Oh my God, oh my God.
Well, I mean, I took
it. I mean, for me, more so than you.
I'd say, I mean, loosely tell this story, but I took a day off for my birthday. I passed on a shoot with a client for my birthday, and she used someone else, and then that was that. That's how fast it happens.
That's how fast it happens.
2 years. It's like the second you're not available for something.
So, I mean, our jobs make sense for our charts, for
exactly.
Sure.
No, but that's the thing. You're magnetic for what you need to work on. So if your self-worth is dependent on somebody else, you're gonna bring that into your life over and over again until you decide it's not.
So good. That's where I'm at right now.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's always that way. You're always being sort of tested in that way. Cause that's it. And then it makes you feel a little bit nuts. Cause you're like, see?
See, I can take a day off. I can take care of myself. I can have a birthday party.
As opposed to that's how it's supposed to be.
There is forever a line of people who are ready to take your job. You know, there's a very long line. And God bless, like listen, also God bless them. Like I think everyone ends up with whoever they're supposed to end up with.
Totally.
There is enough work for
everyone.
And that's
the surrender.
And also the surrender too is like, this was obviously not for my highest good.
That's right.
So it's being removed for a reason. Like send everyone on their way with so much love and light and whatever alignments are meant to find each other. We say this all the time, like there's a million clients.
Yeah.
You know, like they end up where they're supposed to end up.
Yeah.
Most of the time they come back. Sometimes they don't, but it doesn't matter. Either way, it's about just like letting go, right?
Letting go and the surrender. Yeah. So like we were saying, Maeve has Pluto in her chart, so she's had to deal with underworld experiences, you know, painful experiences, death and rebirth, right? Mm-hmm. So you have that theme pretty majorly as well. You have it to your Venus, you have it to your Sun, you have it to your Mars, you have a lot of Pluto. And, you know, your Venus was born hidden behind the Sun, which is in the underworld, in darkness. So
there's... What do you mean by in the underworld, in darkness?
Yeah, that is how we sort of define a Pluto complex. And very specifically, your Venus was so close to the Sun that she was hidden behind it and in the dark when you were born. We also have what's called Pluto complexes, where it's an aspect. This is mathematical. And you have it on almost all of your personal planets. So it tells me there's a theme in your life of death and rebirth, just like Maeve, but it's pretty extreme, you know, an extreme amount of Pluto. So you've had to go through challenging things where you often felt disempowered and overwhelmed and being forced to surrender. And through that experience, through sort of being disempowered, you ultimately rise from the ashes and find empowerment. But it can feel crazy making, you know, it can feel illogical, irrational. Right. You can't power your way through things or just ignore it or pretend it doesn't exist. It's like you're having to be forced yourself into surrender, and that's not fun.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. And then I always wonder what was going on, what transits were happening around when I was 8, because then I got type 1 diabetes on my 8th birthday. Well, that's when I was diagnosed, but I knew something was wrong with me from like 5 on. Like I had to pee all the time. Like I was a really skinny kid. I'd be like, I'm really sorry, I have to go to the bathroom. I'm in these like weird preschools, you know, where the teacher's like, you just went. And you're like, I know, but like, I gotta go. You know, like those kind of things. You're like, oh my God. And I remember saying to my mom, I was like, Mom, I knew something was wrong for like, since I was 5. And like, what's going on? And she's like, I know, I wasn't ready to deal with it. And you kind of appreciate the honesty a bit, because you're like, I had to be like on a really strict diet from when you're like 8, like in down to like, okay, you have to eat every day at 7:30 a.m., 2 carbohydrate exchanges, 1 milk, 1 this. At 9 a.m., you eat this. Like every day for
because of
years.
The diabetes.
Yeah. Yeah. And you're like, this is crazy. And my mom was like, you know, really fear-based and like scared of it. And then you have doctors telling you as a kid, every doctor is like, yeah, if you don't, if it's not under perfect control by the time in 10 years, you'll like lose a leg or go blind. Like, it's crazy. You're like, you can't say that to kids. I'm like, I'm gonna be 18, like what?
But you know, you guys both are very interesting, complex, dynamic, intuitive, fascinating women, you know?
You.
And no, it's an honor to kind of meet you guys and do your charts and commune with you about it just because you get it, you know? And I think when you're on this path, it's a path that you're both on.
I just have a question. Does it ever get easier? That's what I would like to know for me. I mean, does it at any point lighten up a little bit?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
I mean, that's the idea of this. If there is sort of anything is to ideally be this sort of mirror where you can at least understand what's happening and surrender into that, and hopefully that makes it a bit easier.
Yes.
Because often we're fighting against everything, or we think we should be somebody else, or there's
totally.
As opposed to, okay, I understand this is happening, I have choices, I don't have to take it all so personally or seriously, just get very objective about these things and think,
neutral
wow.
observer.
Yeah, from a very big soul level, okay, I'm in here, none of this means anything. All the, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
We get so stuck in the little things, what this person thinks, what that person, none of that.
It's
that's
funny,
operating on the lowest
you
vibration.
You bring this up, my therapist sent me The Guest House by Rumi in a moment where it was like exactly what I needed to hear. Essentially, it's a poem that's basically like, every day, new experiences, new feelings, new energies are gonna arrive, invite them in and let them beat the out of you. It basically says like, let them, you know, let it destroy your home. You know, just allow it and laugh and smile and thank them because they are teachers. They are experiences and the lessons that you need to learn.
That's right.
You know, well, and I try and remember that because when life gets hard and the moments are happening where you're like, I don't know if I can handle this. It's actually if you just like completely let go, surrender and like allow it. Oh, okay, cool. You all want to talk? Cool. Bring it on. Because you know what it is for me is it's actually an opportunity for me to heal my bullying from my childhood.
Absolutely.
So although it is debilitating for me to go through it online specifically, and especially because I was bullied online, it was the early days of like AIM, Instant Messenger, you know, when I was like in eighth grade. And so I would get bullied all day and then I'd come home and I'd get bullied all night as soon as I turned the computer on. And so now, as a 34-year-old, as these trolls, you know, come after me for whatever, truth, untruth, whatever it is, it triggers that little girl stuff for me, you know, that little trauma. But the blessing of that is it's like, oh, okay, cool, this is my opportunity to heal this.
Right.
And thank you guys,
thank
you me. Know, thank you. Why not take this messy situation and turn it into something beautiful and light, you know? And that's my responsibility, I believe, on this earth. I talk about my clients all the time and people, you know, this video came out about me like, you know, trying to protect Megan. There was this fight. I was, and I said on a YouTube video, it's my job to protect my clients. And a lot of people were like, no, it's your job to be a stylist. Okay, here's what I have to say about that. There's a lot of stylists out there who are amazing. And maybe they do just deliver clothes and they move on and they don't get their energy wrapped up with people. But I really believe, and I know you believe, that the way you make people feel is why we have our jobs. There's a lot of great hairstylists, but people feel great, and that's why they choose to have you around. So when I say it's my job to protect her, that happened to be a very literal situation where I literally ran into a crowd of people.
As you would, you're an Aries, yeah.
Right? But also, I mean that in a way of like, energetically, I try to uplift and protect the people that I have the honor to work for. It's just who I am. I understand that's not for everybody, and I know that not everyone chooses to operate that way. And by the way, it is hard, and it does suck me dry a lot of the time.
Yeah.
You know, but it's just the kind of being that I am.
Well, it's in your chart. You're gonna protect the people you love. That is, I mean, what is amazing about all of you guys is what we're talking about too. You are this warrior protector. You are this brilliant, creative person that can manifest in the world. You are a seeker of truth. So these are the gifts.
Yeah. Right.
You know, you are deep.
No, and it's
you are a powerhouse, you're a Scorpio, you feel deeply, you're able to manifest in the world, you're this Capricorn, you hold everything together for everybody. I mean, that is also the gift.
Right.
You know?
I have literally manifested my entire life.
Of course.
Yeah. And so sure. Like everything but I've
that's
ever wanted.
What you're great at.
Minus the guy. But he's okay, he's coming.
And the first thing on my list always is emotionally available. Or emotionally intelligent, sorry, that's what it is. Emotionally intelligent.
Available.
Yeah.
I constantly joke, I'm like, my dude's like been with my therapist already for like 5 years. You know, he's like already doing the work.
That's right. You need somebody who's already doing the work.
Already doing the work. Not like, oh, let me catch up. I'm so doing the work and been doing it for so long.
I know, when that someone's it's like, brand new,
no,
it gets a little like,
no,
it's tough.
It's not it for me. Well, God bless everybody. Cheers to that.
Oh, you guys are amazing. Thank you.
Thank you for doing this.
I'm
so happy we got to do this, that people got, you know.
Yeah.
That I could continue to share myself with the internet who's not nice to me. Like, I have a really bizarre, like, I'm like signing up for more torture. I'm like, oh, they're mean to me? Let me start a YouTube channel.
Cool.
No, but I love that we could get into your chart because I mean, people should know who you really are. Because I'm sure there's such a projection based on how you look or what your life's about. They don't understand who you really are and how relatable you are.
I'm happy to share that. And I also feel like to continue to help to like raise the vibration of this planet is so important. It's why the Local Love Club exists. It's why you exist. It's why you and I found each other. All right, well, you guys, thanks for joining us on this journey. Like and subscribe to this channel if you like what you see. I promise I'll get more back to the fashion. And please make sure you guys download the Pattern app. It is the most mind-blowing, interesting experience you'll ever have. I promise you will like it. And also follow Mother of Pattern. Mother, what is it? Mother of the Pattern?
Mother of Patterns, yeah.
Mother of Patterns. On Instagram and Laura Polko.
Don't download it unless you have like 3 hours to go deeper.
Go deeper.